What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, I'm Daniela. Welcome. I do tips and tutorials for kite foiling, and I'm also gonna start doing some vlogs about just kind of what I'm up to so that I can keep you guys updated. So definitely subscribe if you're not already so that you don't miss any of that. Today I'm gonna be talking about how to go fast upwind. This has been a very highly requested video, so I'm super excited to be sharing these tips with you and just telling you kind of what my preferences are, what I've seen some other riders do, but also just kind of encouraging you to try your own things and seeing what works best for you. So yeah, let's start talking about how to go fast. The first thing I want to mention is that different riders have different techniques and preferences that they have kind of realized works best for them. So that's why I think it's really important for you to try your own techniques, see what works best for you, because what really works for me and what I like to do may not necessarily work for you. So I really encourage you just to keep an open mind and try different things out, see what you like, and that will be the best way to really figure out how to go fast for you. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is gear. If you really want to go fast, you need to have a higher aspect foil and a higher performance racing foil kite that is also high aspect. The nice thing about race foils is that they're really stable even at high speeds. A lot of free ride foils, once you get to a certain point, they're just not going to be stable enough to actually keep trying to go fast. The other thing I recommend doing is getting a higher performance kite that has a high aspect ratio, just so that you can optimize your upwind and downwind angle. Even if you don't want to invest in really high performance gear, that's totally fine, because everything I'm going to tell you is going to be really applicable to free ride gear as well, and that way you'll still be able to go as fast as you can on regular free ride gear. So next, let's talk about kite position. So when you're going upwind, your wingtip should be pretty close to the water. Obviously, it's not going to be touching. There should be like 1 to 3 meters between the surface of the water and your wingtip. Additionally, you should try to move the kite as little as possible. So the only way it should move is upwind and downwind based on when there's a gust or a lift. The next thing I'm going to talk about is board and foil position. When you're going upwind, you want to find the perfect balance between speed and angle. You get your angle by pointing the board more upwind and edging to heel side, and you get more speed by flattening the board out and pointing the board lower. I think it's really important to remember that your board and foil position is really dependent on rider weight and the size of your board and wing. So for example, for me, I'm usually riding a little bit of a wider wing than a lot of people, and also my kites are pretty high aspect, so they point really well. I'm also lighter, so I automatically am pointing pretty high compared to a lot of other riders. So instead, I usually focus on riding a little bit flatter so that I can keep up my speed. The next thing I'm going to talk about is stance. Stance is probably where it gets most complicated, but it's also where you can make the most gains, and it's where you really have to find what works best for you. So for your legs, when you're going upwind, your front knee is pretty bent and your back leg is relatively straight. Also, your front leg is doing most of the balancing. So when there's chop or a wave coming, your front leg is gonna be the leg to either lift the board up, put it back down, and just is always adjusting the pitch of the foil. If it's wavier or if there's more chop, your back leg is going to be less locked. Your upper body is leaned towards the back of the board. I notice a lot of riders are oftentimes really hunched over when they're going upwind, and a lot of times there's almost no space between their shoulders and their neck because they're kind of in like this. But what I prefer to do is I try to keep my shoulders back a little bit more and my back more straight, just because it helps me feel a little bit more relaxed. And I feel like when you're like this, you're really tense and it's almost harder to kind of move and adapt to different conditions. Whereas when you're a little bit more relaxed and open, I feel like I can just adapt a little bit more to what's going on. This is something that's pretty minor, but again, it's just something that I prefer and I think has really helped me with my comfort level at high speeds. For my setup, my main sheeting area is pretty far out. So my arms are usually pretty lengthened, but I know a lot of riders like to be a little bit more closed. Again, this is just a personal preference, but I feel like I can handle a little bit more power and bigger kites when I have my main kind of sheeting area a little bit higher up in the bar throw. For holding the bar, I have kind of a weird thing that I do where I cross my thumbs like this and I am holding the bar almost right in the middle and my D power line is underneath my thumbs. Again, this is like really weird and I think I'm the only one that does this, but it's a super personal thing. I think that's just how I feel most comfortable because that way when I'm going upwind, I don't move the kite at all almost because my hands are so close to the middle of the bar. Whereas if you're holding the bar further out, you're more likely to make these really subtle movements on the kite that may not be intentional. Another thing is that I hold the bar really, really lightly just so that I can feel the kite as best as I can. Again, so that I can make some really quick adjustments and whenever I feel a gust, I sheet out and head upwind a little bit, or whenever I feel a header, I just go more for speed and things like that that just help me stay comfortable while also maintaining a high speed. In terms of where I'm looking, I'm usually looking just upwind of me and upwind of my kite. This is just so that I can look for pressure, so I can kind of anticipate whenever there's a gust coming or if there's a header, I can kind of prepare for that and maybe tack early. This is something that is really important for racing. If you're trying to go fast and be the fastest one around the course, you want to maintain course awareness and know where your competitors are, but also know where the pressure is on the course. So just to kind of review everything, for your stance, you're gonna have your front foot bent, your back leg relatively straight, your upper body is going to lean toward the back of the board. I like to hold my hands in the middle of the bar. That's a super personal preference, but it works really well for me. And I'm always looking upwind to look for any people or any pressure and gusts that are coming toward me and my kite. Okay guys, that's it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss the downwind edition of this video coming very soon. And like this video if it was helpful for you and if you learned something new. So thank you guys so much again and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye.